to another beautiful day. For our Jewish brothers and sisters, they have a tradition of the Sabbath or Shabbos, where they rest and they stop from the busyness of their week. And as Christians, a lot of us have forgotten that tradition of stopping. And this morning, as we pray, I invite you to actually stop. Stop the busyness, stop the thinking, stop the doing, and just be for a few minutes. It's a really healthy thing to do. It's also a spiritual thing to do, to center the self, to be more mindful in the living moment. And so this morning, we use the word Marenatha, an Aramaic term which means come Lord. So as we breathe, we breathe fully into the depths of our belly, we say that term silently, Maranatha, Maranatha, as we breathe. And if we get distracted, immediately come back to the breath and come back to that prayer word. Will you pray with me? I hope so. Let us begin. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Maranatha, come Lord Jesus. Thank you. Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you for praying with me. It's good to pray with each other. Today we are using again the resource As Mary Did. And the next part, which is contributed by the Marist brothers, it's called The Main Point, Part 23. Under pressure from all sides to provide brothers with new schools, Marcelin had difficulty in ensuring enough time for their complete formation. So he made sure that support were in place for what was essential in the life of the brothers. So this comes from the book, The Life of Marcelin Champagne. The dearest wish of his heart, however, was to inspire his brothers with a love of prayer, to lead them to understand its importance and benefit, and to train them in this holy exercise. In this instruction, he was always returning to his subject, which he called the main point. It was his view that to have the gift of solid piety is thereby to possess all virtues. Here is how he developed the idea. If God bestows on you the gift of prayer, he grants you at the same time all virtues. For it can be said of prayer what Solomon said of wisdom: all good things come to me together with her, in the Book of Wisdom, chapter 7. In fact, it is impossible to converse often with God without acquiring his spirit, without becoming like him, by the imitation of his virtues. So I have always noticed that one who had the spirit of prayer also had the spirit of obedience, of mortification, and of zeal, and that he was wholly occupied with the attainment of perfection. Pious brothers are the pillars of the Institute, and no matter what may be their talents in other respects, no matter what their strength and their health, they are useful everywhere. They spread good spirits all around, and God blesses everything entrusted to them. We must probably owe the blessing of God on the Institute to this or that brother who is perhaps considered useless because he has few talents or is sick. Yet he is extremely dear to our Lord and his mother because of his solid piety. End quote. And a reflection. Solid piety is the essential virtue for all times and places. Champagne had the spiritual institution that if his brothers excelled on this point, he could take his leave without worry. That intuition remains valid today. His insistence in this regard is a source of inspiration for personal growth and in ministry. Earlier in the year, Bishop Vincent Long of Parramatta made the point, speaking to some school leaders, that COVID, so this idea, the pandemic that this year we've been going through, has sort of released or made us aware of a false fallacy that we're alone, that we're isolated, that we're individual, and that we're trying to get through it by ourselves. And the reason he said that was the need for connection, the need for community, the need and recognition in our humanity of the other. And sadly today, in Western countries like Australia, up to 90% of Christians no longer practice their faith. They don't go to church to pray. And so we've lost this idea of prayer. And reflecting on it, I actually think it's not as much to do with the church itself in terms of how we practice and the different ways we practice, but there are actually other areas of prayer which are critical. So both for the individual, do we spend time in our day to stop, to center ourselves in all the different ways that we can pray, but also in our family, do we spend time, do we actually courageously and creatively try and connect in a spiritual way and just spend a few minutes, maybe 5 or 10 minutes, praying together? Because I think that, you know, those major pillars, both as an individual, within a family, they actually have to come first before we can pray in community. And so we're designed to live in relationship, and prayer allows us to actually invite God into that relationship, into our world today. So I really encourage you to pray like those early brothers, like the brothers today, and like all Marists. In the communities that I've lived in the Marist communities, prayer was a significant part. And in one community in particular, I remember some young adults struggled to get up in the morning to actually come together and pray. But it makes such a difference because it connects us and it makes us part of each other and part of God. Thank you for listening to me today. I hope you have a beautiful day. God bless. Bye-bye.